Hello guys, this is Thomas from Hotkey404, and in this video I will show you how to create a completely free Let's Encrypt certificate and how to use it with Asterisk in TLS registrations. Okay, so actually this is the second video about Asterisk TLS registrations. In the first one I showed you how to create a self-signed certificate and how to use those in SIP and PJSIP channels. Today I will show you how to create and generate a completely free Let's Encrypt certificate, and of course you will need a public IP address for that. Today I will show you how to use Snap to install Certbot on CentOS 7, then we will use Certbot to generate our certificates, then we will use renewal-hooks to overcome some binding problems in web servers. And point number four, we will create a custom script that will allow us to use those newly created certificates in Asterisk TLS registrations. So let's get started. Before we generate our certificate, it's good to start by properly configuring the DNS service so that when, for example, you run a web server, you'll be able to access your server using a fully qualified domain name. To install Certbot, we will log into our server via SSH, and then we'll install Snap. And Snap is available for CentOS 8 and 7, starting with release 7.6, and is included with extra packages, this Apple release. Since I am logged in as a root, there's no need to do a sudo before every command because it won't make any difference. So we will install with yum install Apple release. And before we continue, it's good to verify that you do not have your Certbot package installed in any other way, like using apt, dnf or yum, so remove it before proceeding. After adding Apple repository to the CentOS installation, install snapd package with yum install snapd, then enable snapd socket with systemctl enable now snapd.socket, and create a symbolic link ln-s var lib snapd snap into snap. Then follow the command snap install core and snap refresh core to make sure that you have the latest version of snap. If you see an error that it's too early for operation and device is not yet seeded, just wait a few seconds and hit the same command once again. To install Certbot, we will do in the command line snap install and then classic version of Certbot. In a second, we will see a nice message. After installation, we will create a symbolic link necessary to run Certbot with ln-s and then snap bin certbot into usr bin certbot. Now to actually generate a certificate, you have a choice to make. If you execute certbot cert only and then web root, you will use this option if you need to keep your web server running. For example, you have a web server that already uses port 80 and you do not want to stop it, then this is a choice for you. Second option that we will use in our example is standalone. And this is if your web server is not currently running on this computer, then the certbot will temporarily start the web server, create a certificate and disable it. And we will use the latter option. In the first step, we will provide an email address that will be used for urgent security notices. I agree to terms of service, but I am not willing to share my email to receive some news campaigns. And in the last step, the most important one, I will enter the domain name I would like to receive my certificate for. So let's encrypt hotkey404.com. And you will see an error. And this is on purpose. I will show you two most common problems with this generation of certificates. First is binding to port 80, because our web service is currently running, so certbot cannot use the same port. To solve this problem, I will execute systemctl stop httpd and once again execute the command providing our domain name. As you can see, now we have a different error. There is a problem with the connection, and this is because if we check the IP tables, you will see that port 80 is not open in our firewall. Hence, we will do nano etc sysconfig IP tables and add our port 80. Now, after reloading the IP tables with systemctl reload IP tables and once again executing certbot cert only standalone and providing our domain, after a second we will see a nice message that we successfully received the certificate. As it says, certificate and key are created in etc let's encrypt live let'sencrypt.hotkey44.com. But if we do ls-l and check this directory, you will actually see that these are not the files itself. These are just links to archive that contains those certificates, but for us, it doesn't make any difference. To renew the certificate, we will be using certbot renew command, and this is the one that we will enter into our cron. As you can see, it is not generating the certificate because the previous one has not expired. It was just created. So to test if this renew action will perform as it should, we can use certbot renew dry run. And this simulates renewal of actual certificate. As you see, all simulated renewals succeeded, and this is because our web server is still off. If we turn it on, we will once again face an issue with binding to port 80. So to solve this problem, we will be using renewal hooks. To use those renewal hooks, we will go to etc, let's encrypt, and then renewal hooks, and inside you will see a few folders. The pre folder contains scripts that will be executed before our renewal action and post after. Let's enter the first one, so cd pre, and then we'll create a file nano and any name, for example httpd.sh, and this will be a shell script that will do just one action, systemctl stop httpd. So this will stop our web server before generating the certificate. Then after giving permissions to be executed with chmod plus x, we will go to the second folder with cd, some dots, and then post. Here we will create a similar file, so nano httpd.sh, and inside we'll create a script that will do the opposite, systemctl start httpd and give execute permissions. If you now run certbot renew dry run, you can see that the simulation is completed nicely, but just to show you that it actually works, I will do nano dots pre and command the line with stopping our server. If we execute once again, you will see the problem that it did not stop the server, so we have a bind problem. So if we go back and remove this command and execute once again, this certbot for a second stopped our server, renewed the certificate and started it once again. So it works really nice. Now I will show you how to automate the process of using those certificates in Asterisk. In a previous video, I showed you how to generate self-signed certificates, but now let's use this lesson crypt. First, let's start with ls-l etc asterisk. Here we will create a directory with make dir etc asterisk ssl, chmod 700 to do some permission restrictions, and this folder will be used by asterisk user with chown asterisk colon etc asterisk ssl. Then we will create a hook that will automatically copy our certificates to this new directory. So cd etc let's encrypt renewal hook posts And here we'll create, let's say, nano asterisk.sh. And this script will first remove all of the files, all our certificates in the directory. Then we will copy all the certificates from etc, let's encrypt, live, and we can go with asterisk or our specific domain and all PEM files into etc asterisk SSL. Then lower the permissions with chmod 600, all of our certificates with etc asterisk SSL asterisk.pm. Change the user chown asterisk colon and etc asterisk SSL asterisk.pm. And if you want, you can finish with the command that will reload your SIP or PJSIP channel. To finish, we will chmod plus x asterisk.sh to give this file an execute permissions. As we see, now we have two files with post hooks. So we will execute certbot renew dry run. And if we go to our folder with ls-l etc asterisk SSL, you will see that certbot generated the certificates and then copied all of our newly created certificates to asterisk directory with right permissions and the correct owner. So now we can easily use those certificates in our SIP and PJSIP channels. Before we start, let's change the user because we know that the files are owned by asterisk users, so su asterisk, and then ls-l etc asterisk SSL will show our certificates. PJSIP configuration is done in etc asterisk pjsip.conf, and here we will create a new transport. Let's name it transport TLS, type transport, protocol TLS, bind zeros with the port 5061, and then two certificates, cert file, etc asterisk SSL cert.pm, and private key in the same directory, etc asterisk SSL briefkey.pem. After saving, we will enter asterisk console with asterisk hyphen r, some v's, module reload res underscore pjsip.so. And now, since PJSIP automatically selects the transport, we will log into our phone and we will change host into our fully qualified name, port to 5061, and transport from UDP to TLS. As you see, the phone is registered and in our console it shows contact with transport TLS. In SIP channel, the configuration is a bit similar. Let's enter etc asterisk sip.conf, and here in general section we will add TLS to our transport methods, TLS enable equals yes, TLS bind port address we will set with port 5071 because 5061 is used by PJSIP, and our certificates, TLS cert file, etc asterisk SSL cert.pm, and TLS private key, etc asterisk SSL briefkey.pm. Having that, we will go to asterisk console and do a SIP reload. We can see that TLS SSL certificate is okay. So once again, we can go to our phone, and on the second account, I have SIP channel. So we'll change host to our FQDN, port to 5071, transport from UDP to TLS, and we can see that the account is still registered, and in our console with SIP show peer 100, we see that the transport is changed to TLS. To conclude our configuration, we can go to etc let's encrypt and our renewal hooks post asterisk.sh, and since we are using both channels, we will add asterisk rx to execute SIP reload, and same line asterisk rx module reload res underscore pjsip.so. Last thing that we'll do is to add our renewal as a cron job. So let's edit etc cron tab, and every 10 days, we will execute an action as a root that will do certbot, renew, and in quiet mode. Systemctl reload crond concludes our configuration. Of course, all of those steps are described on our website hotkey404.com and link is in the description. In case you don't want to go through all of that process, you can easily buy a certificate for something around 5 euros. But then every year you'll have to buy the certificate and replace some certificate files. So why not use completely free Let's Encrypt? So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a wonderful day and see you in the next one.